designer William Stout says they're the same.
It's a visual storytelling like film, except that it's on paper. And it's not that big a leap from doing comic books to doing storyboards. And if you do detailed enough storyboards, you're, in essence, designing the film.
Stout made the leap from comic books, like this cover of Alien Worlds, to film on Conan the Barbarian. He was part of a team of comic book illustrators brought in to design the Hyborian era for the film, or to use his term, to undesign it.
We took Viking cultures, samurai cultures, and we knew that, say, at 1000 AD, these cultures looked like this, and they evolved into this 1,000 years later. So we thought, what would happen if we devolved them 1,000 years? What would they look like? You have to believe the culture exists. That's the key. Because if you don't believe it exists, you don't have any right to expect that your audience will.
Stout's most recent project was The Return of the Living Dead, the first film he designed single-handedly. For inspiration for the macabre satire, he turned to the lurid EC comics of the 50s, like Tales from the Crypt. One of his characters looks like it just slithered off the page of one of those comics, the Tar Man.
One of the challenges was to design a melting suit, to design a skeleton suit of a corpse that looked like it was melting, and not have it look like a man in a suit. A lot of times when you design a man in the suit monster, they put a stuntman in there who can't act. And as any fan of Frankenstein can tell you, it's the actor that makes the difference.
Stout's own taste runs to the bizarre. In his cluttered studio, he keeps an 800-year-old Peruvian mummy head and an Egyptian mummy's hand from the 26th dynasty. The latter is serving as an inspiration. For his next film, Invaders from Mars, Stout is undesigning the Martian culture from ancient Egypt. Dennis Michael, CNN, Hollywood.